वेलकम। चैप्टर नंबर 4, मेंटेनेंस एंड रिपेयर मेथड्स फॉर मशीनरी, पार्ट 1, प्रेजेंटेड बाय प्रोफेसर खमकर यूपी, वर्किंग एज अ लेक्चरर इन सिविल डिपार्टमेंट, विश्वेश्वरय अभियांत्रिकी पदविका महाविद्यालय, अलमला, लातूर। इन दिस सेक्शन वी सी following points: types of cracks, causes of cracks, development of cracks in structures, cracks in masonry structure, cracks in plastering. So first, introduction. The success of repair activity depends on the identification of root causes of the deterioration of concrete structures. If this cause is properly identified, satisfactory repairs can be done for the improvement of strength and durability. Thus, extending the life of structure is not difficult to achieve. This is the flow diagram or tree diagram of types of cracks. The types of cracks basically divided into two parts, that is before hardening of structure and after hardening of structure. Then moved out to causes of cracks in masonry. Some causes due to cracks are developed in masonry. First one, foundation failure, which is due to decay of soft soil. Second, ground movement due to clay shrinkage. Next, decay of building fabric, that is due to woodworm, rust, etc. Moisture movement that cause materials. Thermal movement that causes also material. Tree root growth or growth of vegetation. First, moisture changes. Most of the building materials like concrete, bricks are porous in structure, so they absorb moisture from atmosphere and it will shrink on drying. It is a cyclic process. Due to this shrinking and drying, cracks are developed in structure or wall. The moisture changes are depends on following factors, which are cement content, water content, curing, chemical composition, and grading of aggregate. Now we will see how moisture changes affect the structures. These are the cracks developed due to moisture changes in masonry. Nearer the cracks, there is a dampness or moisture which affect the structure and develop the cracks. Foundation movement or ground movement. In these, shear cracks are developed due to following reasons. First, uneven bearing pressure. The bearing pressure is uneven below the foundation affect the cracks. A load is greater than safe bearing capacity of soil. If the structural load is greater than the safe bearing capacity of soil, then shear cracks are developed at the foundation. Less safety factor while designing the foundation. While designing the foundation, we calculate the ultimate bearing capacity of soil. This ultimate bearing capacity generally depends on the safety factor. If safety factor consideration is wrong, then the design of foundation is also wrong. And local variations in nature of supporting soil. The supporting soil of foundation nature is varied as place to place. This is some examples of foundation movement cracks. In figure, the foundation is moved out from the base, therefore the diagonal cracks are developed at the foundation. Second example, soft clay soil. If the soft clay soil is available nearer the site, then the foundation will weaker and movement of foundation will start, which is shown at the base of structure. Next, thermal movement. All materials more or less expands on heating and contracts on cooling. When this movement is restrained, internal stresses are set up and make causes of cracks. It depends on the following factors: temperature variation, coefficient of thermal expansion, which is we utilize to calculate temperature stresses, that is alpha TL. The alpha is the coefficient of thermal expansion, which is depends on material and temperature. The dimensions of component. Thermal movement cracks are developed, then these cracks occur around the opening due to drying, shrinkage and thermal movement of a building. These are the some examples of thermal movement cracks. Now, next is elastic deformation. This is a basic cause of cracks. Structural components of buildings undergo elastic deformation due to dead load and live load. This elastic deformation causes cracks in the structure when walls are unevenly loaded, when beam or slab of large span undergo excessive deflection, when two materials having different elastic properties. When walls are unevenly loaded, it means the walls distribution or load distribution is uneven. When beam or slab of large span undergo excess deflection, when the dead load and live load are increased in the structure, the deflection also increases. When two materials having different elastic property. This is the best example is masonry and window. At this joint, there are two different materials which are connected at. This is the example, the window and masonry are connected each other. The elastic properties of these members are different, so the bonding is not good and the cracks are developed. Growth of vegetation. The roots of a tree usually spread horizontally on all sides. If they are around wall, causes cracks in wall and in foundation. Growing of roots of tree causes dehydration of soil, which may shrink and cause foundation settlement. If the roots are growing, they dehydrate the soil, which may shrink and cause the foundation settlement. This is the example. In circular portion, we see the roots are growing. Due to this root growing, unequal settlement caused by these roots close to building. Roots absorb the moisture and causes the clay to shrink. Now move on next part, that is cracks in building components. First, in masonry structure. In masonry structure, at different points we see or observe the cracks. These component are as follows. First, cracks at ceiling level in cross wall, at the top of wall and below the ceiling level or slab level. Cracks at the base of parapet, at the junction of parapet and slab, at the top most floor. Next, horizontal cracks at below the slab level, at lintel and sill level. Next, diagonal cracks. Vertical cracks below the opening in line with window jamb, top floor of the corner, around the staircase and balconies, side walls at the corner of tall building. Now see one by one these type of cracks. The first, cracks at ceiling level in cross wall. In the circular portion, we will see the cracks at ceiling level in cross wall. The cross wall means the walls which are built in construction. The cracks are developed below the ceiling level or slab or RCC slab. And these cracks are due to temperature variations. It will occur. Next, cracks at the base of parapet wall. At the topmost floor, at the junction of slab and parapet wall, the horizontal cracks are developed. These cracks are seen in elevation as well as section. In circular portion, these cracks are due to thermal expansion coefficient or drying shrinkage property. Next, horizontal cracks below the slab level. We will see the cracks below the ceiling level. Those cracks are diagonally or vertically, and these cracks are horizontally, which are available below the slab level. We will see in circular portion of elevation the horizontal cracks below the RCC slab. These cracks are developed due to deflection of slab or lifting of slab edges. If the load of slab is increases, the slab edges are lifted, and due to this, at horizontal cracks are developed. Horizontal cracks at lintel and sill level. At the junction of window, there is a portion of sill or lintel. The bonding is not good, then these horizontal cracks are developed. This is in circular portion, the lintel level cracks are seen, and these cracks are due to drying shrinkage and thermal contraction. Diagonal cracks in cross wall. This is the diagonal cracks in cross wall. These cracks are developed due to differential stresses in internal and external walls. Generally, these diagonal cracks are developed in external as well as internal walls. The external wall having different temperature. Due to this, differential stresses are developed. Diagonal cracks over RCC lintel. The diagonal cracks over the RCC lintel are as shown in figure, and these cracks are developed due to drying shrinkage. Vertical cracks below the opening in line of jamb. This is the example of vertical cracks, which is exactly in the line of jamb below the sill level. And these cracks are developed due to large window opening and differential shrinkage. Vertical cracks, top floor. This is the vertical cracks at the top of floor. And these cracks are developed due to shrinkage of slab and thermal contraction of walls. Vertical cracks on sidewall. This is the vertical cracks in sidewall. These cracks are developed due to thermal expansion. The reasons of cracks, we will see these reasons in above, and we will see in tabular format. Thank you. In next part, we will see the repair methods for masonry structures. Thank you.